humidity that they're about to face out there.
Yeah, it's hot out here as we're underway. Samoa running right to left. This is Pool B up against the Aussie Sevens. Here is Paul Scanlon. Switch a play to Maliko, co-captain with Matavao. Ball's chip forward on the chase. Is Maliko, but Nick Maloof does well for Australia. Josh Turner's there, but they get the penalty. Do some more. Really good start for them from this game. They've been out of the action. Haven't played a lot of elite rugby sevens for some time. It'll be really interesting to see how they go. Paul Scanlon now stretching the Aussie defence, and they're going to get the first score. And it's Ioana Sione in the corner for Samoa. They are up and running in Singapore, the former series champions.
Yeah, impressive finish there. Brian Lima, coach, will be happy with that. Sione's fourth World Series appearance. So one of the more experienced guys. They're going to have a quick look upstairs. I don't know, Charlotte, do you see this one? Do you think he kept his feet out of touch? What do you think?
Well, I reckon he stayed in here.
Ooh. It's that left leg. What do you reckon?
I think it's off the ground. Well, yeah, I should probably be saying that he's out, though.
You're impartial on commentary, remember, yeah. Charlotte, so keep to your original thought. Ooh. Is that simultaneous,
yeah,
to put down on the foot over the line?
Good neutrality there, Charlotte. Great shot from
we
our
can
crew
award
here.
The try. Thank you.
And you heard it there from our TMO. They're going to be able to award it on screen.
Try awarded for Samoa. What a start for them. An excellent beginning for Sione and Samoa. Wide out conversion opportunity. Doesn't make it. Charlotte, you'll be heading off to Canada in a few weeks' time. An opportunity to seal the series for the Aussie Women's Sevens. You've had a great start so far.
Yeah, we have. We love going to Canada. It's one of our favourite legs on the circuit. So we've actually never been able to secure a win there. So I think for us that would be awesome because we love going to the place and playing over there.
Yeah, April 30th, May 1st. Langford is delighted, looking forward to having the women in town. And what a great time to be involved in the women's game right now with the World Cup coming up. We've got the World Cup of Sevens as well, Calm Games. Must be pretty refreshing for you to have all these opportunities.
Yeah, we've got so much going on at the moment, and I think all Corey tool and space is always dangerous. Yeah, we've got so much happening at the moment in the women's game, which is awesome.
And how about the inside ball from Corey tool, and how about this? What a score it is for Matt Gonzalez. The inside ball indeed, and Gonzalez on debut has a try for Australia.
Well, you said it, Corey tool made it happen, didn't he?
Yeah, I think every time Corey Toole touches a ball in a bit of space, he yeah. seems to create something almost out of nothing. It's just that outright speed that he has.
And how is it with the men's team? Obviously, the coach here coaching them right now, John Manenti, that you know very well. And they actually swap roles, the two coaches. Fantastic to see.
Yeah, so after Dubai, our coaching staff swapped teams. And I think it's been going really well. We've both been successful since. And I think both John and James Stannard, their assistant coach, are really well suited to the men's side.
Yeah, you've had a bit of a switcheroo with the head coaches, haven't you? Tim Walsh and John Minetti switching roles. Chucky Stannard as well. How's all that worked out?
Yeah, I think it's been great. Everyone's still really enjoying it, and we've been successful ever since, so I think it's been the right decision.
Yeah, well, you won a gold medal under Tim Walsh in Rio, let's not forget, so perhaps the Aussie Sevens women can do it again at the next Olympic Games in Paris. Here comes Samoa, back to business, trailing Australia by 7-5. Really good start for them, the try to Sione, and now they go the chip and chase. There's no sweeper, but look at Nick Maloof, alert to everything. The Aussie captain, he gets back and saves the day under the attention of Maliko. Here's Josh Turner, Henry Hutchison, who captained the Aussie Sevens in Malaga and Sevilla. In the absence of Nick Maloof, there he is again at scrum half. Try scorer Gonzalez, Gonzo as he's known. Great moment for him. Inside ball from Toole. What a pass it was from Corey Toole to Gonzo for his first try. Samoa looking for the jackal at the breakdown, but Hutchison does really well. And they do get the decision to Australia. Here is Corey Toole. He's been absolutely brilliant on the series so far Australia's leading try scorer. And how about the feet from Josh Turner? And how about the inside ball to Ben Maher? And another one, but it's been intercepted by Sione. Read it really well, did the Samoan try scorer. Scanlon. Maliko in midfield, carried on by Afasua. A little error on the floor, though. Good work from Corey Toole.
Charlotte, you mentioned you've been working with HSBC and some young people here. So we take a look at the replay. How important is it for you, that role that you have as the star of the World Series, to inspire and bring on that next generation of kids?
Yeah, I think it's obviously something that I hold very close to my heart. I love encouraging young kids to play rugby, and being a girl growing up, we didn't obviously have many role models to look up to in rugby. So, yeah, I think we play a very vital role in just growing the sport and getting more girls involved.
And we can expect you to remain on the series for a long time. Your second all-time appearances for Aussie Sevens. Plenty more left in the tank?
I think so. I definitely want to try and get to Paris. So after that one, I'll reassess to see how much I've got left.
Yeah, big couple of years of Sevens coming up. As we said, World Cups, Commonwealth Games, Olympics looming on the horizon again. Here's Dietrich Roach, who's played every game for Australia on the series so far, as has Henry Hutchison. There's Ben Maher arriving quickly, the 13th man for Australia. He's on debut as well. Can he do what Gonzalez did and get a try? But here is Corey Toole, who is rocket fuel, but not much opportunity there in space, and a really good turnover. The extra roll, you heard it from the referee.
Yeah, just one too many, Corey Toole. And that kick has gone into space. It's a foot race.
No sweeper for Australia. It sits up nicely. Samoa looking to go ahead here, but what a tackle from Dietrich Roach. But they get up. They go again on the side with the try for Samoa. And they take the lead here.
Huge smile for the 20-year-old debutante here. Working as a team, the nudge, a little bit of blocking off the ball there, and a little bit of a soccer dive. But there's a fair contest for this ball. It pops up, and significantly, he was tackled initially, but not held, so he got up. Great awareness from on his side. And that's the finish. Points for Samoa.
Conversion doesn't make it, but Samoa, what a start it has been for them in their returning match here on the HSBC World Rugby 7 Series. Steve Onosai, what a finish from him. We will restart play. This is the final play of the first half. That's gone out on the full, so we will go back for a restart now for Australia. A bit of a let off for Australia there just before the break.
Those restarts and sevens are so crucial, but the boys definitely need to get some points on the board leading into half time, and I'd hope to think they might put a sweeper back there. I think
Kicking game for Samoa has been really interesting, hasn't it? They've used it a lot.
Yeah, they've identified that Australia's not playing with a sweeper, and I think they've regathered almost three, so I think at halftime they might make some changes there.
Yeah, Nick Maloof, he's one of the leaders in this Aussie side. Roach, who came up with that tackle that couldn't prevent the try. Gonzalez now, here's Hutchison. He's got Corey Toole to his right, but that ball has gone to deck. And he's picked it up in an offside position, has Turner. So Samoa, before the break now, will get an opportunity to perhaps get the score they couldn't. There's another decision, not back 10 Australia. Paul Scanlon wants to go quickly, has to go back to the mark.
For those of you new to rugby, the half won't end on a full penalty, so Samoa will have another chance here to stretch this lead.
So trying to work the narrow channels on the far side now are Samoa Niue. They look in really good shape here, this Samoa Sevens team, under Brian Lima, of course, head coach. Well prepared, even though they haven't had a lot of rugby, but there's the turnover on the floor for Australia, and now they'll try to respond. Here's Hutchison running away with it. From the Randwick Club in Sydney, he tries to offload it off the deck, does really well. Corey Toole now with a bit of space, shows the ball to the defense, little in and away, but reading it well was Matavau. Turner. Hutchison. Back to Ben Maher, but that ball has gone forward. That will be a half-time in this match. It was a strange old end to it, but not much in it at all. Samoa. A lot of us were wondering how they might fare here with not a lot of rugby on the belt coming into this tournament, but they've done really well in that opening 7 minutes. They lead Australia by 10 points to 7. For Australia on debut. Converted. And it will be Dietrich Roach who does a lot of the kicking for Australia, who will get us started in this second half. Left footed restart from Roach, and look at that, flying through the sky is Josh Turner, and he scoots over the line. The Aussie Sevens with a piece of restart perfection there to get the go-ahead score against Samoa.
Well, if COVID did anything, it gave you hours on the training pitch, and that is technical supremacy. Beautifully weighted kick, and the timing of the run by Josh Turner, just pure class.
It looked like a wobbly hole kick from Dietrich Roach, didn't it? But you see the end result, and absolutely that was the plan.
Sometimes the kick that isn't high and hanging is more difficult for the defender to deal with. And he took that in full stride, did Josh Turner. Sort of a flat kick. And the defender has less time to kind of adjust as opposed to a big high hanging kick.
So 6 minutes ago, plenty of time. 12-10, Australia leading Samoa. Third seeds against 18th seeds here. Roach again. Again goes to that far side, slightly low trajectory, and Turner again wins it for Australia. That's the money off the restart for the Aussie Sevens. Roach. The Western Sydney Two Blues, and Henry Patterson is out there. He's from the East Club in Sydney. Brumbies boy Corey Toole involved with Roach there. Loose ball, but plenty of time for Josh Turner to pick this one up. On a strong run. Here's the Aussie captain, Nick Maloof. Morris Longbottom, there is an 11 shirt. Brilliant semi-final performance from him in Sevilla to get them to the gold medal match. Longbottom, that's gone out of the hands of Turner. We've seen a bit of that today. A lot of moisture on the ball, of course. High, high humidity here in Singapore. Well done off the floor from on a side, but that's gone forward. And Corey Toole has it. And now Nick Maloof can't reach out, but Corey Toole will dive over for the easiest of scores. Manu Samoa with the error under their six. Australia capitalise.
Well, that was cruel for the Samoans. They've done the work defending. An awkward bounce went between the legs. A little bit of patience here. But as Rob Vickerman told us in our expert view, Australia scoring through the middle. The middle third of the pitch is their most productive. Over 70% of their tries come from there. The pressure on Samoa, got the ball, and they found a hole in the middle.
That's number 22 for the season for Corey Toole, Aussie's leading try scorer. Roach bangs over another couple. All of a sudden, Australia gain a bit of control over this one.
They do. There's four debutants in the Samoan side. Well, more than that, actually. They've done really well, but just a moment like that can completely undermine, and you see there the flow of the game.
Yeah, cracking start from Samoa, wasn't it, with the try to Sione, really well worked. The chip through from Scanlon for on offside, but Toole, Turner and Gonzalez have scored for Australia. Slightly different kick this time. Higher, but didn't go the 10. That was Morris Longbottom with the restart on that occasion. Roach has gone to the bench.
3.5 minutes, heaps of time in the Sevens game. Those restarts productive for Australia, but that one cost them.
Running into contact is Fialangi. Nui. Good tackle on him from Hutchison. And Maloof goes in and secures the ball. Now a turnover for Maliko. Well done. It was Sione as well. They have the ball back. Samoa, they got the decision.
Roger.
Got to score twice. 19-10, Australia lead. That's two scores. Good feed here from Saltui Huta. That's gone clear. Big hit coming in from Tim Clements, another debutant for the Aussie Sevens here in Singapore this weekend. There's Scanlon. The experience of this team, and bursting clear from the ruck is Steve Onosai. He has a double, and he's put Samoa back in this one.
Well, Onosai is just clinical here, but I've got to say, this Samoan side has found something. Coach Brian Lima, manager Tuala Patliota, they brought this group together, playing for each other. They're actually staying on my floor in the hotel. They're singing, they're wearing their traditional gear to dinner, and I think they found a little something here, and that's a great response from the youngsters in the blue jerseys.
Oh yeah, Onosai, what an influence he's had. Conversion is successful. So, 2 points the difference. 2 minutes to go. Make no mistake, this would be an upset if Samoa could get one over the Aussie Sevens, who are third on the standings at the moment. Samoa have played very, very little rugby sevens as a team in recent times. Longbottom at scrum half. Hutchison first receiver. Patterson now in midfield. Shows it. Goes it. Up over his 10-meter line. Morris Longbottom arrives. Little step from Clements, the debutant. There's Turner again, who's been influential. Here's Stu Dunbar inside to his skipper Maloof. Referee just ducks under the would-be pass. Falonico, he doesn't buy the dummy. Straight in on Maloof. Here's Longbottom again. Australia, 2 points up. A minute to go. Longbottom skipping through tackles. Here's Patterson. Henry Patterson. Penalty Australia. Maloof won't go quickly, just wants to slow this down now, work the clock.
Yeah, a bit of high contact there about the shoulder line, and watch as Longbottom walks over in the white boots. A little sample of what he can do on that previous play, but now he's just going to take his time, nudge it into touch. We're inside our last minute here. Just the contact rises up. Not much in it.
It's a hand, if anything, wasn't it? 40 seconds to go. Samoa need the ball. Australia in control. Turner. Little hitch kick from Turner. Gets away from the tackler. And another one. And the dummy Turner. Almost there. Kiwi born. Aussie seven star. Patterson with the pass to Tim Clements. And the debutants for the Aussie sevens. They've done really well here. They've come off the bench and they've scored tries for Australia.
Yeah, just dancing out of that tackle, keeping his feet, not allowing himself to be wrapped up. You see the calling on the right, and then finally short of the line, but the patience, no white line fever here. They stop, they regroup and reproduce. And in the end, Tim Clements gets a soft one, but almost loses it.
Yeah, Josh Turner's been the main man for the Aussie Sevens in that second half. Crucial try led to the second. Clements has sealed the deal for the Aussie Sevens. They are up and running in Singapore.